Today, we live in a day and age when we run towards evil. We compete with one another who can pull more girls. We compete with one another in who can drive the fastest car. We compete in one another in chasing after the dunya. We compete in one another who is bigger and harder and better. You see one lad, he's in the gym, he's training, he's benching 150. There's a lad next to him, it's competition. Man's got to be bigger than him, man's got to be stronger than him. He's got to have bigger arms than him. Hakikat, that's the reality, that's the way life works today. If he has a house, I have to have a house bigger than his. If he's got a slick car, I've got to have a slicker car. I've got to have a car that looks even better. Why? Because we're competing with one another in this dunya. We're fighting against one another. We compete with one another in bad deeds, in proving a point to the boys. How often will you compete with one another to prove a good deed? How often will you compete with one another to say who can read the longest salah? How often will you compete with one another and say, let's see who can remember Allah Almighty the most? You don't, because it's not interesting. When the child gets to 16, 17, he's grown up now, he's got a mobile phone in his hand. And all what's it about? At that age, he wants freedom. He wants to get out there. He wants to enjoy life, get out, buy a car, pass his driving, zoom the streets of Leighton and Walthamstow. That's what he wants to do. He wants to prove a point, have a slick motor. Doesn't matter how he gets it. If he wants to look cool, he will do haram to look cool. He will do haram to look cool, but he has to look cool. You see, it's all about street respect, street rep. He's got to have a street rep. If he ain't got no street rep, he ain't counting. Brother's not known, people don't want to know him. He will only be known if he has the street rep. And what's the street rep today? Today's street reputation, we're too worried about pleasing people. We're too worried about pleasing the boys, pulling the bear. We ain't interested in pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the state that we live in. Look at that. Look how amazing life is. You used to live your life like you were the king. You thought you were everything. You wore the best garments. You were driving the flashiest cars. You lived in the biggest houses. You had the most beautiful wife and children, everything. Despite all of this, despite chasing after the dunya, you know, when you die, where's that house gone? Where are those clothes gone? Those flashy clothes, garments, Armanis that you were wearing, the Fred Perry's that you were wearing, the Adidas and Nike that you were wearing, all this that you thought, I need to look good. When you enter your grave, what are you going to be wearing? Two sheets of cloth, that's it, khalas. Three sheets max, wallah. You're not going to go in there with your night garments. You ain't going to go there with your flashy garments. You live your life like you're going to live forever. But when you will enter your grave, that clothes that you were wearing, those clothes you were wearing, the house that you lived in, that money, bank balance, everything that you've gathered, where is it left? Has it gone with you in your grave? Will it be there in your grave? Will your money answer for you? You're chasing after the maal and dawla today. You're thinking about getting rich and proving a point to people. What point are you going to prove in your grave? We are Muslims. We believe in life after death. We believe that after this world, there is another world waiting for me and you. What are we prepared for that world? We're spending too much time thinking about this dunya. We're building our bank balances, Barclays, HSBC, Lloyds TSBC. We're too busy chasing after this dunya. The real bank balance is what? The real bank balance is the bank balance of the akhirah.